Bulgada, and I'm talking to Malika and Shalini.
Hello.
Thank you for joining us today on Dhanu on Fire.
Thank you.
You guys look fabulous.
Thank you.
It's a hot day, just to let you know. If you see me just breaking into a sweat like music, that's because it's a bit warm. Anyway, great to have you here. And thank you for inviting me. To start things off, this is your property. Tell me about this wave, Bulgada. What was the thinking behind starting such a place?
You gonna start?
Yeah, basically we had the boathouse for a few years, and he was into jet skiing, and we had the entire backup crew, like the guys to help us, and we had a personal chef since.
Okay.
So we thought, why not we start this? And
so we wanted to just convert the whole hobby into a more return giving kind of a model.
Right.
So we've been just going around the country. We've been, you know, going out in the jet skis, like just covering the whole coastal area of Sri Lanka. So then one fine day when all our friends came here, we realized that we are lacking something, and that is a place for the others to stay, to chill.
Right.
So then the whole concept came, and then we have the wave now.
So this wave has like created waves in the last few, y'all started very recently, right?
Not even a year.
There you go.
It's just a baby.
The toughest year for y'all to start.
Yes.
Talk about it.
But we've managed.
Yeah.
We're lucky. We're very lucky that way.
Very good. You guys dabble a lot of things. More than anything, y'all also look really good, which is a bit of a problem. I was like, suck this stomach in, Dhanu. Don't let it go out. It's either me or the stomach. One of us will win today. Tell me about you guys, like, y'all have been seen around. What sort of made y'all like sort of get into all of this, like more or less sort of open out to the public about it? Because when the minute y'all open this property, it loses your little cozy spot, it becomes everyone's thing. How was it to make that decision?
True, because honestly, we were looking at diversifying, you know, our businesses, because we are mainly into furniture.
Right.
So as a family business for more than almost 50 years now, we've been in the business, and it was high time that we take it to the next level.
True.
So then we always wanted something that we are passionate about, not just to start a new business or a new venture, something that we are really passionate about. And lucky that we had all this property being a waterfront in Bulgada. So starting this venture again, as you said, are we just opening it up to the public so that we are losing our privacy?
Mm.
That was always a decision, a tough decision to make. Yet we were lucky enough to partner with Yamaha.
Okay.
So we are actually the experience center, only experience center for Yamaha in Sri Lanka.
That's amazing.
So if someone wants to try out a Yamaha personal watercraft, a jet ski or a boat or any...
You have to come here.
Yes, you have to come here.
No,
so with that, I think we got that exclusive kind of a crowd coming in. And thanks to all these events that we've had at Wave Bulgada, we've attracted the right crowd.
Mm,
I mean, normally, during weekends, you don't see people coming in their vehicles here. Mainly people come in their boats or their jet skis, and they park it and they have a good time and they leave around 6 o'clock.
Wow.
So there's a crowd in Colombo who has watercrafts parked here.
Right.
So then they come here to chill out.
We have their holiday homes in Bulgada.
Right.
So
right.
They don't have a place to, you know, dine properly.
Right. So this provides that as
exactly.
well.
Exactly.
Talking about the hospitality wing, I think you had no problem with her because she has been in the business for too long.
Yes. Yes.
So you were into flying for a long time.
Yes, I flew for almost 10 years.
Okay. Do you miss it?
No, not at all.
Really?
Yeah,
you do?
No, I don't. Seriously, I don't.
You don't
miss
the shopping?
My God,
no,
yes.
No, no.
You because don't miss the visits?
No, actually, really? I don't. I'm serious. Because we actually do travel for a year couple of times. So the shopping is ticked.
Yeah.
Yeah, so
like
then that
done
late.
Enough with
done
that.
Enough. Late
thanks
nights
to COVID,
and
it's not there anymore. Yeah. So she complains, you know?
That's a different story. But late nights and dressing up and dolling up myself at 2 o'clock in the morning, not anymore.
Yeah. But was it interesting when you started?
Super. Yes, it was. It was.
Till
the very end, it was super fun. But then we had all digital media coming in, like all the phones. The time that I flew, we didn't have much of phones.
Right.
Now that I'm that old. then again. So that was fun.
Okay, so because flying is like it teaches so many things. Like there's so much of discipline involved in it. You have no, you can't say I'll be an hour late. Yeah. It doesn't work.
Yes.
It doesn't work that way. So I think you can look into all of this side of.
Yes, of course I do. I
yeah, the, yes. Because you will know it at its best how things have to be clean and neat and nice.
The staff knows it.
The staff knows it very well. They're having a hard time every time she visits here. Every time she comes here. You know, even the dishes to the way the food being prepared and the way it's being presented.
Yeah.
Everything. Even the garnishes.
I go
she's
to the extent of the garnish.
On point to everything.
Yeah. And also she knows first aid, which is a great thing. Somebody goes into labor. If this baby comes out, there is somebody to deliver it. All right. Let's get into a break. On the other side, we're going to see you. We're trying to catch the sunset. This sun is really late, I'm telling you. But anyway, we'll see you on the other side. Do stick around. For starters, we have got like an array of dishes here. What are these called?
That is a seafood dumpling and that's...
It's fried dumpling, right?
Yes, fried
dumpling. Fried dumpling.
And chicken pops with
seafood ceviche.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. And of course, their drinks are great. I'm just going to sip on one of these while we wait for the sunset. We'll see you. Checking out Wave, and you should come and check it out as well. It's amazing. So we were talking about their professional life, but I have to ask Marlita about this love.
Yes.
You all have been together for how many?
Seven.
Was he your first?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
On record, on yes.
And on record.
17 years together.
I know, and kept it to that only.
Yeah.
Was she your first?
Yes.
I mean, that's a lie. Shades the hard work.
Absolutely true.
First.
Truth,
first.
But nothing but the truth.
If you're a virgin, it's my first.
I am a virgin. So tell me, where did you all meet?
Okay, so she was actually captain for St. Lawrence's, and I was the games captain at St. Sebastian. So we've seen each other once or twice.
Yeah, we're Lotham Markham School.
Yes.
Yeah. St. Peter's used to walk by.
Who cares? I've got this.
We are from St. Peter's, okay.
So then I actually saw her in one of our A-level classes in our physics class.
Right. You went for class and you were looking at her.
Yeah.
Basically, like, he was studying and I was not. So he's with all the degrees and all, and I'm just.
So I saw her and I liked her, and then I asked her out. And she was
at the age of 17.
At the age of 17, right?
So before A-levels, right after O-levels?
Yes, right after O-levels.
And did she say yes at the first go?
No, no. She took a little time.
Laurentians are a bit hard like that to get.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Tell me about it.
Yeah.
Right? And then.
Sisters, no. Sisters would have said.
So actually, it took a little time. I mean, it 3-4 months for me to get, you know. For her to know me, rather. So I had to make certain things.
Yeah, because you all have to study, and at the same time, you all have to flirt.
Yes.
Yeah.
So after that, I think I asked her out, and she She said yes in week's time.
That's next class.
So it's a week that we celebrate as our anniversary.
So we have an anniversary week.
So what's the date?
1st of March to 7th of March, which is actually our wedding anniversary as well. So when we got the auspicious time for our wedding, right? So we got it on the 7th year anniversary, 7th of March.
But he never proposed. I mean, why didn't you propose?
I was like, come on, I knew you, I'm going to get married to you. What's the point?
So you didn't have that moment where...
Friends have gone to Paris, they've gone all over the place to propose.
Yeah, because now from a stewardess's point of view, you all want like, you all don't want somewhere here, no? Like, take me to like Bolgoda and all, no? Take me to Paris.
Yes.
But he did it right. It was our 10th anniversary, wedding anniversary this year, and he proposed.
With a big rock as well.
Yeah. With a big rock.
I had to pay the price.
Right. Yeah. What did you say? Thank you for being my wife.
Are you going to do it another 17 more years?
I don't think she had a choice. But it's amazing. What I wanted to ask is, you all work together, you all live together, have children together. How do you all keep the spark alive?
The thing is, we are like...
Chemistry is right.
Right. When you know it's the correct person, you feel it here. Like, he's the one.
Okay. And
not that we don't have our fights here and there.
We do have arguments. But
who's the fussy one out of the two?
No, it's you.
Shut up.
He, you know. Not me, Lani. It's you.
I hope this goes on for another 13 years after this show. when it comes to the furniture business, have you got involved as well with your creativity and all those stuff?
Yes, I am the chief interior decorator.
She's a qualified interior decorator.
Wow. Yes.
So after quitting flying, so she started this interior decorating.
So I do the decorating and we do projects and all that.
Okay.
So
when you all take up a property, you all make sure that the furniture and the look and feel, everything is provided.
Yes.
Okay. Disagreements come there as well?
Yeah.
Yes, always the case. Because I know how hard it is to get the designs done. I'm the one who has to execute it after all.
Like the chair going like this.
Yeah, she comes up with all these crazy designs and, you know, I have to take care of all the manufacturing side of it. My carpenters, you know, they just blagard me saying that...
Hey, miss it about the piece one. Ahasin dhabi budwana. All right, just to speak about the food that we have here. So, y'all have an in-house chef.
Yes.
Okay, and he has been around for a long time.
In fact, we have three chefs. So, one has been there for a very long time. And we have two more because the operation is running at the moment as well.
Right.
So,
but one of these items are your recipe.
Yes.
This one. Try at Wave.
The pork rib.
Yes.
Pork. Okay.
Honey glazed pork rib.
Okay.
No one can do it better than her.
Oh, super. It's not that you are cooking here, no?
No. But if I am too, I will just say that. But
put that with those nails, I don't see you doing any mixing there.
Not really. Because
home front and all, you.
Yes.
Home front, also, I do have help with my three kids.
Yeah.
But you tell me cook. Gloves on and I can do it.
Okay. Yeah. No fussing there.
No fussing at all.
All right.
There are no fussing. All the other things she fusses, but not for this.
Amazing.
She loves to feed us. She's like that Brie in Desperate Housewives.
Right.
She's the local
housewife, yes. Maybe,
but not desperate.
I knew that. Housewife, yes.
You can keep this desperate housewife.
With this, I don't need to be desperate.
I will not know. Just to let you all know. Never mind. All right. Let's get into a break. We'll see you on the other side. I'm going to just dig into everything that's kept here. There's a seafood kotu, correct?
Yes, correct.
And that's chicken.
Grilled chicken.
And that's honey glazed pork ribs.
Yes.
All right. That's just a rundown of the menu. If you do live near Piliandala, I'm telling you, for me, this was the closest location for me to come. And I was like, oh my God, I'm here so soon. It's amazing to know that you can come here so far. So if you really want to just relax and enjoy a sunset, this is a perfect place. We'll see you on the other side with something amazing because it's sweet on the other side. Just go. Welcome back, the final segment, and as you could see, this is how my life should be. I plan my retirement. I'll be here if you all need me for a long time. They're actually showing off to me. So I just have to tell you all a little secret. When they had the launch here, I walked this deck and I cracked the deck. But to be fair, there were bigger people who walked on this deck before I walked. And there were a lot of people. Maybe they could have cracked it, but I broke it.
Yes. You were the one.
Yeah.
Chosen
one. And I got
one.
Highlighted for it as well.
Yes. I remember.
Yeah. It was terrible. And now it's the newer piece of wood that is put there in the middle, which looks like I have broken it.
It has Danu written all over it.
Yes. Today, of course, I walked quietly and softly. Walked like a cat. All right. So, you guys, how often do you all step by this place?
If the place is like free, most of the time we do come here for dinner.
We do
dinner on the deck.
Oh wow!
We do sell that as well, but honestly, we love to have it. Whenever there are no bookings, we come here.
Then we bring the kids. We do stargazing for them.
Yes.
Ah, okay. Yeah. Nice, and also kids today don't enjoy such things.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. True. So you all have three kids. Yeah. You all got married very young, I see.
If you call it young, yes.
Yeah. Yeah. But when it comes to day-to-day living, are y'all like, you know, very conscious about what y'all eat? Are y'all very particular or?
Yes. After three kids and with the age catching up, yes, we are particular.
Where is the age catching up, dear?
The age is not catching up, but preparing for it.
Okay.
So, yes, we do eat right, what you call. So I hardly eat carbs, but we have a cheat day, Sunday. Sundays is our cheat day.
Whole day.
Yeah, whole day is all about.
Sunday is our fun day. So basically, from morning till evening, we take the kids out, we play with them outdoors.
We don't work on Sunday. Sunday is fun day. So the kids look forward for Sunday as well.
Right. Okay.
So it's family day.
Okay.
Feasting, rice and curry.
Sunday binge.
Full time. Now there are so many people who. In the last 3-4 years, they took up, like, you know, the country was looking solid. So they did take up like entrepreneurship. They moved into their own businesses. They took up new avenues in life. And now everything looks so uncertain, like so gray. What would you tell those people, like young entrepreneurs who have taken that challenge?
See, I am a lecturer myself as well. So I do lecture. So I find a lot of people who are taking up entrepreneurship as a career, even at a very young age. So always what I tell them is that don't just give up just because you fail once, right? You stick to your plan, have a plan. You might fall behind on certain things, but have your milestones, achieve them, but go to your end goal somehow. And on top of all that, I always say that be passionate about what you do. I mean, if you see the businesses that we do have under our group, that's always been something that we are always passionate about. I mean, water sports, something that we are always passionate about. Yeah. Even furniture, she's a 3D kid. So if you're passionate about it, you don't work.
Yeah.
You really don't work for a salary. You work for something and you get really that satisfaction, what you call. So my only advice for anyone who's taking up entrepreneurship would be to make sure that you do with a lot of love. You do what you love and you love what you do. Simple. Very simple.
Like it's a tough part because everyone has moved into different avenues and right now they're so worried about it and scared about it because they have to sustain, which is not an easy thing to do. Just to ask you, are these your recipes?
The tres leches is my recipe.
Okay.
I prepared it for you.
Wow.
Yes. Especially for you.
You know, I can never say that name.
Tres leches.
Yeah, it's such a hard name. So without killing the French. It's French, right?
Is it? I'm not too
something
sure.
Let's say it's French. I don't know.
It's Latin America, if I'm not mistaken.
I don't know, man. Please don't scold me in the comments, okay? I just wanted to warn you there. But I just say 3 milk cake.
3 milk.
Yes. It's the same thing, no? I'm going to give it a bite because this became such a Columbo's, everyone wanted to eat.
Yes.
The one who is on the diet is the one who is going for it. That is good. You all live close by, no? It's like 11 minutes from my house.
Yes.
I'll be here more often. Just let me know when this is in the fridge.
Super.
All right. So, wanted to speak to these guys. If you are checking out Wave Bolgoda, you know the faces behind it. Such a good place to come and relax. It's always nice to bring out new people and tell their stories on these shows. It's fun to create new people and new stories, always what inspires everyone. Thank you very much, guys, for inviting
for
us
us
here.
Thank you very
thank
much.
All of us here. And if you're planning on, you know, running away to a less crowded place, this is amazing. it's actually really nice to relax. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Danu. We love you. Thank you for having us.
Thank you so much. We will see you with another cool episode 2 Danu on Fire. Till then, you keep smiling. It's a wrap.